Hello YouTube users, my name is Rupsy and today I'll show you guys how to create the house behind me. Let's first of all do a little spin around. This is the house I came up with. It's a bit of a fantasy styled house and I was actually thinking of doing a time lapse about this house, but I forgot to record it. So yeah, it's going to be a tutorial right now. So I hope you guys enjoy this and would want to follow along. But very quickly before we move on with the tutorial itself, I just wanted to say thank you guys so much for the huge amount of support lately. We are already at, what is it now, 870 subscribers. And yeah, I did not expect this amount of support at all when I started my channel. And I know just in the whole spectrum of YouTube, I am still a small channel, but I appreciate every single one of you guys watching my videos. Also, I haven't really been able to upload that much lately and I'm really sorry about that. I just didn't have any inspiration at all. So it was very hard to just start recording and making something. So yeah, I'm sorry for that. But I hope to make all of you guys happy with the tutorial we're doing today. It's probably going to be a long video and I just also wanted to point out I will make it without all of the extensions, like the part over here. We will do the chimney actually in this part over here, but like the garden over here and this all of these leaves like this and this little wall over here, I will leave that out. But the details like on the house, like this window sill over here and that kind of stuff, we will do. But then after we build it over there, and I have also laid it out right there, I'll show you guys how to do like the extension bits over here. I'll just show them in greater detail than I'll do right now. But yeah, first things first, the bottom layer we'll do right over here. But I'll show you guys how big the house is going to be and then the supplies you need for the bottom layer. These are the dimensions of the house. It is a 11 by 15 block rectangle with a bit of an extension at the front, which is just a 5 block gap over there. Bricks are for the chimney and we'll just use only bricks for the chimney with also some stairs and stuff in there to flesh it out. Also a bit of a side door next to the chimney over there, which is just 3 blocks of the orange wall right now, and that will be the side door. So yeah, bear in mind, we'll do it without the detailing right now. So the main blocks you need for the first floor are these right here. These are stripped birch, sandstone and smooth sandstone, oak planks, light gray stained glass paint, bricks, just spruce doors and spruce trapdoors. And then later on, we'll add the little details like, for example, this overhanging windowsill. But I use a lot of different blocks for that, so I wouldn't be able to flesh all of them out over here. And to make it just a little bit clearer, I will remove these 5 blocks and place some grass over there to just, well, get rid of any accidents later on. First of all, let's place your stripped birch logs on all of the blocks except for like the orange and the brick part over here. So leave 3 blocks over here, 1 over here, diagonal behind it, then 1, 2, 3, 4 more. Go around the corner, 1, 2, 3, skip 4 blocks, 1, 2, skip 3 blocks, 1, 2. And over here, it's just with this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and connect it all the way to there. Once you have this, we are going to replace some of them immediately. Those are these two at the front. So as you can see right over there, move this block and get this one as an oak plank as well. Move all the way to the back, remove these two, replace them, skip one and these two as well. Then over here, we're going from the front because it makes it a bit easier. Skip those and this one as well. Two over here and two over here, leaving the 1 block gap as well. And you know what? Let's actually place the windows on these oak planks right now. With your light gray stained paints just on top of these wooden planks. Go up by 2 and yes, it does look a little weird right now. But we'll place in the walls right after this one. And right now it's very easy, I'll do it all out of smooth sandstone for now, but just raise every block by 3 and just go 1 block above the windows and do this all the way around. And for this part, of course, with the bricks, just a nice 4 by 4 square it is going to be right now. And just keep on moving your walls all the way up. And yes, we will also need a couple of smooth sandstone stairs for this doorway and that doorway over there. And I'll do that once we have all of the main walls in here. And for the front door, just on these stripped planks. Well, stripped birch logs, I mean. So as I pointed out, we do need some smooth sandstone stairs as well, and place them in right over here. You can just connect this up right there. And do the same on this doorway as well, connecting it up the top, like that. Then we just have to mix in a bit of sandstone, and I do this very sporadically at the bottom. Just remove a couple of the smooth ones and place in some sandstone wherever you see fit. Just mixing it up a little bit, it makes it look more textured, and well, it is still a flat wall, but it makes it look a bit less flat. Let's actually get the doors in. I'll just remove this wall over here real quick, and placing your door on this block, so one behind the wall actually, on the front of this block. Then move into the house and get your trapdoors. I'm just holding my shift button for this. Click them like this and then flip all of them open to get your nice arched doorway. Do the same over here. We'll just do it again for convenience sake. Just get rid of that. On this block right here, so one behind these strips and birch logs, placing your door, move inside your trapdoors all the way surrounding them, holding shift, flipping them open, and then on the outside, as you can see, the nice arched doorway. For the chimney over here, I just thickened it out a little bit, so maybe something like this. I could even place one block over there or something, and something like this will actually be fine. Place in some stairs as well, some upside down right up against there could even look cool as well, maybe even something like that, who knows. And then I'll just actually move that up like this, just making it look very crumbled on the side, and I think this looks quite nice actually. Okay, that's even better. It looks a little bit weird having just the ones there over there, but I think this is fine. We'll probably fatten out this chimney a bit more later on, because I didn't really take in mind that we'll go quite tall with this one. So this might look a bit off, but we'll see in the near future. But for now, without the detailing, the bottom part is done. Let's move on to the second floor, which I've laid out over here. So we'll need some smooth sandstone with the stairs, some chiseled sandstone, I think just only two of those, but we'll see. Normal sand, spruce planks with the stairs as well. This is stripped dark oak planks, white stained glass, the regular spruce door with the trapdoors, but also wants the dark oak door with some trapdoors over that. You still need the bricks for the chimney, a couple of prismarine stairs with also the dark, what is this again? The warped trapdoor, and some node blocks. So this is just the main blocks for the shapes and stuff. And then once again, like the details like this and stuff, and the plant box and that kind of stuff. Also the dark oak fence thingies over here. We'll do that at the end of the video. I'll do that over here as well. That will be like the final part of finalizing this house. And then the other details like this, I'll show you guys after that. Let's actually start at the front over here with two of the chiseled sandstones at the side. Then upside down regular upside down smooths there. And then go up with some of the smooth sandstone and maybe some sand as well. Until you reach pillars of 4 high from the chiseled one. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Then get your smooth sandstone stairs, place one over there, and this is all we will do for right now. Well, that's not entirely true. We also need the spruce planks over here, and this looks a bit weird right now, but once we have the balcony in, it looks fine. Let's move on to the strip of stairs over here, and we'll actually need some placeholder blocks right over here to make all of this. So from this side, placing your upside down stair, and go all the way around like this. Skip the chimney over here, so it will actually be easier to go from here. Place it against the placeholder block, and then go all the way like this until you reach the chimney, and we'll skip not all of these actually. We get one in here as well, and one in there. And then from here, just placing your two bricks, because the chimney will go up from there. And let's actually first of all lay out the windows this time, and they will be quite similar to the bottom one, but it's a bit more. So it's the same at the front, just right over there, place down some node blocks, because there will be the bottom block of the window. over here as well, just on top of this one, but also add one to the right of it, because it will be a bit bigger. Then over here, place in two over here, two over there, just on top of this one, then skip one and place one more. Then at this side, actually go from here as well, place your blocks right above that. And then two from here, place one over here, skip one, and one over there as well. So from above, it should look like this. Let's raise up all of the walls on this side, and for this one I'll go with the stripped dark oak wood and then mix in some spruce planks. I also have the dark oak planks to go above the windows, and all of these windows will be too high, so the dark oak blocks will be right over there with the window in here, and we'll add that after the walls. So for now I'll just go, let me actually remove these placeholder blocks for now. But for now we go 1, 2, 3, and 4, and then after that I can just mix in some of the spruce planks. But I'll show you guys how to do that a little bit later on. For now, just place in all of the walls. I'm going with the dark oak stripped looks, but you can also begin with the spruce planks if you're doing this in survival, because it makes it a bit more material sparsely. I'm not sure if that's the right word for it, but we're going with it. For this side, just go up with the bricks again, and we'll just thicken this out a little bit in the end probably. And actually on this side with the second door, or the second balcony actually, just skip these three so that you have two more to go over here. And just fill the top part up with some spruce stairs, just like that. And then we can also already place in the planks over here, because the balcony will be right over here. When the walls are placed in, it should look like this, or it should look like this with the spruce planks everywhere. And then the dark oak planks above all of the windows. Now we're going to mix it in just the same as we did down below. And I'd like to make it look like there are some patches of this wood over here, and just mixing them in, well, basically all around the place. And personally, I like to leave a bit more of the oak logs than the spruce planks, but of course, that's all up to preference and you just do you. So it should look something like this. Let's first of all place in the windows at the spaces we've already allocated for them. So skip the part over here, obviously, and then just above all of the node blocks and in between the node blocks and the dark oak planks, just place in your white stained glass. Just like that. Then for the doors to the balconies, we'll actually need some more placeholder blocks right over here. And these actually aren't placeholder blocks. This is where your floor should be. And you could go down from here, maybe just like that, and then eventually create it so that the floor is going a bit up towards the balconies like that. This again is all up to you. You could actually just get the floor level in like this, but you will have a bit of a smaller second floor if you do that. So for the balcony at the front, we'll just use the spruce again and just go with what you already know surrounding the door over here. So then it looks like that. And for the other one, we'll actually use the dark oak one over here. I did that wrong. We have to go inside of the house, surround the door like this, if I can place my trapdoors correctly, flipping them all open, and it will look like that, which is also very nice. And this is actually already where we are starting the roof. Let's actually begin on this side over here, with the bit popping out like this, and then just a upside down like that. I would go higher like this, because this is actually where this part would stop, but that will already be part of the third floor, so we'll leave it like this for now. Continuing this side is very easy. Just get your row of regular dark prismarine stairs like this, and then the upside down over here as well, which will go up later on. Going back to the front over here, it is just the same as the other side. Regular stairs and the upside down over here as a starter to go up. Then all the way over here, we'll just have the same, but on this pillar-ish kind of thing, just one away from this spruce stair, we'll go with an upside down against that one. And we'll actually do the same on this side. So for here, we can actually just already do it like that, so that this corner is done as well. But for over here, we'll actually extend one of the warped trapdoors over there. And this will be some sort of archway, but because this is still the second floor and the archway isn't anymore, we'll have to leave it like this for now and come back to it once we are starting with the third floor, which actually is right now. So we're starting with the third floor and also the roof, and all of the blocks we'll need for that are right over here. And these are again the main blocks for building this, and the details will be the last part of this tutorial. So we're having smooth sandstone with the stairs, sand, dark stripped oak, spruce planks, and the dark oak stairs. They will need birch trapdoors and dark oak trapdoors to make the round windows, as you can see over there. For the glass in the windows, we'll use the white and light gray stained full glass blocks. Then bricks for the chimney again, and we'll top off the chimney with two campfires, a couple of acacia trapdoors, two walls, and two flower pots with the brown mushrooms to kind of round them off. As you can see, I did over there. It's probably very tiny on screen, but you might be able to make it out. For the roof rim, we'll use the dark prismarine stairs and slabs, and also just a small amount of the warped trapdoors. For the roof itself, it's going to be cyan terracotta and grey wool. And also, all the way at the top, we'll have some green full glass blocks. As you can see over there, I made some sunlight windows. I'm not sure if that's the right term of it, but at least they look cool. And let's actually once again start with the front facing part over here. First of all, we need a rim over here, and I'll do this out of... I'll actually mix in the sand already. But apart from this one and this one, it's all going to be sand from up here with the stairs as well. So going up one layer, two sands at the side with the stairs like this. Then going up again, which is two sands, and then two sands again with the upside down stairs like that. Coming up with more sand, and for this one you actually need to place in the birch trapdoor first, because otherwise you cannot place this one or that one. And you know, just to make it look nice, we'll already place in the birch, and because of my dumb OCD-ish stuff, I want them to be on the sides like this, so that it looks like it's going around or something. I don't know, I think it just looks better like this. Then on the inside of the house, I'll actually place in the gray ones on the sides of the stairs, make it like a little round with the white ones, and then with the light grays in the middle again, which makes it look like this, and it's just a nice pattern. Then on the sides, let's actually just start on the sand. Go one out, upside down, regular, upside down, regular, then an upside down against this sand block with a slab on top of it, and from this side again going up, not like that, but like this. Upside down, regular, upside down, regular, and that finishes the front part without any of the added details, which we'll do in a little bit. Let's raise up this part over here, just simply going all the way up like this, and it actually means that we need to replace this stair like this. Now you can mix in some of the spruce planks over here as well, maybe something just like that. And I know I did a simple stair pattern like this, but actually from this side of the window upwards, we'll close it off like that. And for right now, I think it's actually easier to get a little bit of the roof done. So starting from here, going all the way up like this. Oh, not like that, but like this, except for the bottom one, or the top one actually, which we'll place in like that. And we can actually extend it like this for right now. Yes, I know this tutorial is a bit over the place, but it will be easiest to do this part over here right now. And then mix in some of your roof blocks just like that. I don't know what I'm doing, but something like that looks fine. And then this part, we'll just leave it like this for a tiny little bit. And I think it might be easiest to start working on this side first of all. Then go 1, 2, 3, 4 and 1, 2, 3, 4 just above the pillars we just made. And we'll mix it in a little bit. Place in just a row of blocks over here. And let me just actually mix this a little bit. And we actually need our dark oak stairs for this part, because this is where the other window is going to be. And I forgot to bring the dark oak trapdoor, but that's fine for now. Let's go up just a little bit, like, well, maybe like that. And then we'll place in the window over here as well. Let me just collect the blocks for them. First of all, the trapdoors, these ones are a bit easier to place in because they all look the same from all sides. Then from the inside again, the light gray ones on the stairs, and also in the middle after replacing the white ones like that. So you have the nice, well, kind of a cross pattern over here, or a checkerboard maybe, like that. For this small archway over here, we will place in two trapdoors just like that. Two slabs over here and one slab right over there to make a nice subtle archway. And let's actually place in a part of the roof over here as well. Just like this, going from the outside all the way up like that. Upside down stair over here with a slab on top of that. And from this side again, going up with the upside down stair, upside down stairs and the regular stairs just like that. And as you can see, it's actually starting to look like something already. Yeah, I'm not sure how easy this will be to follow along, but we'll try to create this part over here. First of all, for convenience sake, I'll close this row up like that. And you don't need those over here to save a little bit of space on the inside, but it makes it a bit easier for me to let you guys follow along. Then over here, again, this row you won't really need. But this row over here you will, and I'll just mix it in a little bit with our nice mixing blocks. And then over here as well, let me just place a placeholder block over here with some of the wall blocks like that. So this is the row that's all about, because that will be the visible row from the outside. And for now we can place in the roof blocks over here. So again, with the cyan terracotta and the gray wool, just mixing them in a little sporadically, apart from the chimney part, because the chimney will go up over there. Something like this looks really fine. And let's just get the chimney going up like that to make it a bit easier, because we also have to connect the roof over here, which goes all the way past here, and connecting them up over there. There will be a bit of detail over here, but we'll do that later on as well. Let's just get the chimney going up a little bit, like that, for now. Let's actually move on to the back of the house, which is probably the side I should have started with, because it really is the easiest. Just go up from here. 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then go down again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, and just the 1 over there. And then you can mix it up with your spruce planks again. Make it look maybe something like this. And then it's just as simple as connecting the roofs together like this. Upside down over here. Going down until you reach the other side with just a little slab on top of it. And this is the back of the house. And then you can actually proceed to connect this part up to right there. And also fill in some of the walls over here, just getting some placeholder blocks down to mix it up a bit to finish this part over here as well. Alright, so right now we have this, which is still a bit of a jumbled mess over here, but let's move on to this side for now. And again, for convenience sake, I'll place in a lot of blocks over here just for me to fiddle with. And I forgot to lay them down over here, but we'll actually need some white stained glass paint for this part as well. Let me just fill in these wall over here, all going 3 high. And then we'll punch out the windows once I have this wall in. But make sure to stop the wall right over here instead of going all the way to there, because this makes it look a bit nicer. Then the windows will be right above those. It's just those two, so it will be on line with the roof over here. These two as well, so that they're the same. And then this window will be in the middle of those two. It's also just a one. And then let me just place in a few of the spruce woods. Just something like that maybe. And then we can place in the white stained glass paint right over here. This also makes it a bit easier to connect the roof. So just go all the way over here. And turn the corner right over here. And connect it up to right there. And again, you can fill in this little spot right over there. So that it's closed again. And believe it or not, right now it's only the roof that is left to do. So first of all, let's actually find these little spots over here and fill them up with some of the blocks, just like that. So let's do the roof, which again is a little bit difficult. Let's start on this block over here. Go in like that. It's going out like over here, around the corner to connect it up over there. So it should look like this. Then go one above that. That's the wrong look. just mixing in the roof blocks once again until you reach the point over there. Then let's actually go on this side over here, connecting it all the way up just above these wall blocks we've just placed in, turning the corner over here, which is again the wrong block, and then connecting it up right to there. Then the second row, just follow along again, placing in the roof blocks over here, going to this corner, and then actually connecting it up all the way to right over there. And then you can also connect this part over here up to right there, and finish this side off with just two slabs over here. Then using some slabs until you are right over there on this side as well. The only thing that's left is this rectangle over here, and we'll fill this one up with, or you guessed it, roof blocks. It should leave you with just this little slit up here. And we do need some placeholder blocks, so I'll just place in some of the glass over here. Then on the both outer sides, we need the prismarine slabs, a 2x2 square of glass against both of those, and then just two of the prismarine slabs in there as well. Removing the placeholder blocks, and that should look like this. And believe it or not, apart from the chimney, this is almost done. The chimney is now this tall, it's on the same level as this roof block over here. Raising it up by 1, 2, 3. Placing in the campfires over here with the acacia trapdoors on the sides of those, and all flipping them open. Placing in the two brick walls on top of the campfires with two flower pots on top of those, and then two brown mushrooms in there to kind of round it off. That should look like this, but that isn't actually the chimney done, because we do need to kind of mess it up just a little bit. But that is just part of the detailing, which we'll start right now. And because I use a large amount of different blocks when detailing, I won't be able to flesh all of them out over here because it will just be too cluttered. But let's start with the front-facing Sandish Tower. Placing two spruce buttons like this on the chiseled one, and two over here as well. And extending these out by two like this with the stripped spruce logs, and a slab in the middle. Placing in two polished blackstone buttons on the tops of that spruce log. Getting three lecterns in like that, facing the inside. Getting some trapdoors over here on the sides of that one to kind of make the border of the balcony. And this is actually the balcony done. And the only thing we need left is just a little bit of a roof over here, with two trapdoors on those sides and a slab in the middle. And then connecting them up to the stairs with some dark oak fence gates, just like that. And that is the front, or well, actually this part of the front is now done. Moving on to this side over here, on the sides of these node blocks, place into grass blocks or dirt. On the bottom of them, I place in some dark oak trapdoors with some regular oak trapdoors on the sides of these, and just placing some flowers right there. Then get some oak fence gates, flipping them open against the dark oak planks with some campfires on top. I like to face them so that the top log looks like it's connected to the wall, and then of course extinguish them to make it look like this. Then I also placed in a little hanging plant over here using a dark oak fence with a chain hanging from there, a flower pot on this block to make it look like it's floating, to place a fern in there because it looks like the chain is connected to that, to make a little bit of a hanging plant like this. Let's move on to the right side, where I first of all thicken the chimney just a little bit. Yeah, I think this looks a little bit better. You can just also place in some furnaces at the bottom over here to make it a bit more useful for survival players, and I don't think it looks too weird, but you could also just leave them as bricks if you want it to look like that. The balcony on this side is the exact same as the front, so I'll just do it quickly while talking over it. So the polished blackstone over here, spruce trapdoors on the side with the lecterns in the middle. If I can just place them in like this, and you should be able to, yeah, you can go out over there to make just a little balcony like that. The top part, very simply, I placed two acacia buttons over there, and for a little bit of an entrance over here, I just placed in two dark oak fences like that. Went up with the acacia slabs just like this, and then I placed in two flower pots with some red looking flower things in there to make this side a bit nicer. I also created the one of the flower pots over here, just the same as the one we did before. So with the dark oak on the bottom, regular oak on the sides, just place in some flowers like that. And then for a bit of roof decoration, I went with the dark oak fence, two trapdoors, fence, two trapdoors, fence. Skip this one over here with a fence and a trapdoor over here. Then you can actually just open or close a few of those to make it look a bit interesting. And I also hung one of the flowers over here. I probably used a chain over here as well. Let me check. Yes, in the regular one, I did place a chain over here with a flower pot from there. Some of the warped roots like that to hang another flower over here. And on the top row over here, I placed two fences at the corners over here and just went with all trapdoors at the back over here to make it a bit easier for myself. Just opening a few of them up again, and maybe something. Let's actually just match them up like this. Well, that's well enough actually. That looks pretty nice. And then on this back part over here, I placed in two fences with a trapdoor opened up in the middle. And I know I hung a jungle sapling from that one, just like that, without the chain on that one. Oh, and by the way, for the chimney, I almost forgot, I also mixed in a few of like these stairs over here. Let's actually do it over there. And you could, if you wanted to, place in some of the walls as well to make it just a bit more ruined than it already is. I didn't do the walls on the regular one, but I just wanted to throw that in there for you to have a little bit of an extra detailing option. On the back wall, on these nose blocks, I once again made one of the flower pots like this, so I won't go in depth about them anymore. Over here, I just placed some acacia signs to add just a little bit of detail, and on this one, I didn't really add anything because I have the leaves going over it, as I'll show you guys in a little bit. Just some oak fence gates above both of these, with the campfires extinguished on top of them to make the top half. Let me get some other detailing blocks. On the bottom down here, I did add in a little bit of a duck down flower pot, but I also added in a couple of the letters over here. And I would do them over here, but I didn't because once again, I have the leaves over here again. And I did also add in once again one more hanging plant over here, which I placed in some bamboo, and this chain isn't the correct way, it should look like that. And then we move on to the left side of the house. First of all, I made a little bit of an acacia rain pipe over here, going all the way down, and actually into the ground I placed a dispenser. Doesn't really matter what way you face it, but this way it looks like it's actually going into something. And then I did some of the roof decorations over here as well. So at the top, I did it like this. Skip 1, 2, 3. Fence, 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 every other one. And then on this corner again with the 3-gap over here, place in the dark oak fence gates, opening those two. Get those in here, opening those two, except for the middle one. And then again, the 3 fence gates, opening those two, so the middle one is closed, and that should look like this. Over at this side, I also left a gap of 3. Then on this side, I did the one on the corner and also left a gap of 3. And the rest of them are all fence gates. And let me actually check which ones I flipped open. So I flipped this one. Then I flipped it on this side as well. I flipped the two middle ones and also the ones on the side of the fences. So that should look like this. And I know this is once again very hard to follow along, but I hope you guys like it either way. Lastly, for this side, I placed in another flower box over here again with the dark oak, regular oak on the sides, and just some random stuff in here. Let's do it like that. On the rest of them, I placed in the acacia signs. For a second, I was wondering why it wouldn't let me place them, but you have to use shift on the notebooks, of course. And then from the bottom over here, I placed in some of the jungle trapdoors over here with the slabs in the middle, and then making it look like the jungle trapdoors are connected to the walls with some dark oak fences connecting from the walls like that. And on the regular one, I actually made it so that the trapdoors are looking like it's connected on this side to the wall as well. But therefore, you need to place placeholder blocks on this side, and that's just too much work for me right now. Apart from the leaves on the back and the extra popping out bits on this side, that's actually all of the details and decorations on the sides of the house done. apart from the roof, where I have just a small bit of extra detail. That is the warped signs, as you can see over here. Just placing them on the sides of the green glass windows. But that is the whole tutorial for the house done. I will show you guys the little details on this one. So first of all, I created a little bit of a pathway going up to the front door using some oak leaves and some of the red flowers, so the rose bush, tulips, and also the berry bushes. And I also made a little bit of a, well, what is it? A briefcase? Is that what it is? Like a postal brief thingy. And there actually is a Dutch letter in here, which this is the way to write letter in Dutch. So I think that looks pretty fancy. I also used some of the mossy cobblestone wall, just a little bit of an iron fence over here for some decoration, and some oak fences in there as well to look like, well, you know, first of all, just fences, but also maybe some tree branches, who knows. I also made just a little bit of a fence gate to both ways using the spruce fence gates over here. And then on this side, I actually just made a little bit of a stone, what is it? Like a stone platform over here with just a bit of a picnic table, some chairs you can actually sit in like that. And yeah, I think that looks very cool. Just on the table, a bit of cake and stuff. This is a just birch stairs all the way around. And yeah, I think that just adds a nice lift in feeling, especially with the cake eaten just a little bit like that. A small little bit of a garden over here, just with a small gazebo, like a nature-ish gazebo on top of it, with some chests and beehives. Well, yeah, that's probably, is it the beehive? Yeah, the beehive, not the bee nest, but the beehive over there to just look like a bit of storage area for maybe your carrots and stuff. And that's just the extra bit. And I also made just a brick wall extending from here using some stairs, full blocks and slabs. To make a few holes in there, because yeah, I don't know, I think that looks cool. Over at the back, as I have mentioned quite some times, I made a lot of leaves, just spruce leaves, going all the way up to make it look very overgrown. And I mainly did this because on this side I didn't really know what to add, and it was very bland. So it was like, you know, when in doubt, just spend some leaves. So I did that, removed a couple of the roofs and stuff as well, the decoration that I did, because you won't actually notice it that much when you're just looking at it like this. It just looks more overgrown. And just placing in some of the oak fences and also some ladders to kind of make it supported. Or, well, of course you don't need to support it, but it makes it look a bit more supported like this. And I actually really, really like this addition. I also placed in a few berry bushes at the bottom for some red dots in there. This is a dug-out flower pot. Also using a lot of the mossy stone and just a bit of cobblestone. And then down there, some pot soil and coarse dirt with some pink yew flowers, which also looks very nice. I placed a bit of water underneath there to place in this sugar cane for just a bit of other green shade in there. I don't know, I think it looks quite cool. And just a bit of jungle leaves in here as well. I think that's, apart from this side, that's all of it done almost. So over here I wanted to make a little bit of an extra overhang using some unlit campfires, spruce slabs and spruce trap doors, just to make it look a bit more like timbered, like the guy that lives here timbered it himself. And this is just a bit of a workspace. We got a crafting table over here with a little chair, a flower pot just for some extra greenery outside. And here are a lot of the furnaces and blast furnaces down here, even a stone cutter and a cauldron to make it look like, oh, it's very hot. Get this thing, get the very hot liquidish iron out of there and extinguish it like that. And also just a full set of netherite, because why not? So basically that is all of the decorations I have done to this house. I did do a little bit of interior at the bottom floor. I know I told you guys I didn't, but I actually came up with a very cool, interesting design over here, and I just wanted to show you guys. This looks like a nice way to sit with the fire next to it, and right now it's unlit, but actually placed in some dispensers underneath these campfires with some flint and steel in there. And when you press this button, it actually turns on. So that's just a very nice, smart detail, I find that. And then I placed the shovel over here for you to extinguish it once you're done with it. But yeah, I just wanted to show you guys a little bit of that over here. I don't know, I just think it's quite cute. And also just a little bit of a kitchen I did over here with the bottom side of a barrel, which actually looks very close to spruce wood. So there is a lot of storage in here with some furnaces. And yeah, I was kind of bored. I wanted to do a little bit, so I was like, yeah, you know, why not just make a little bit of an interior over here. Also, this is the space you have in the top part. It's not too much, and it's just this stair isn't really placed in smart enough, but you know, you do have quite a lot of space, so I reckon if you guys build this in survival, you have plenty of space for all of your stuff and plenty of space to make some nice bedrooms and stuff. But yeah, that is all I have time for today. I need to edit this video and get it out as soon as possible because yeah, I just really, really need to upload another video. But thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you liked the tutorial for that house, which also is this house. But you know, thank you guys so much for watching. My name has been Rupsy. I hope to see you guys in the next video. Please make sure to like the video if you did like it, and make sure to subscribe if you haven't already. Once again, my name has been Rupsy. This video has been all over the place. I need to close it right now. Goodbye.